My name is Kiwa, and I'm a Native American soldier in the Vietnam War. As a hatchet-carrying, Bible-thumping, devout Baptist, I see myself as the moral compass of this platoon. I'm talkative yet introspective. I feel it's my place in life to help my fellow soldiers deal with their emotions, whether it's matters of the heart or the consequences of killing other human beings. My best quality is my compassion for others. My worst, some would say, is my distrust of the white man. In my platoon, there were a variation of unique guys who all carried something from home with them. All had their own reason for doing so. Ted Lavender was a grenadier who was notorious for his pill-popping, weed-smoking ways. Tranquilizers got him through, until the day he was killed by a gunshot wound to the back of his head. This event is a catalyst for Lieutenant Jimmy Cross's burden. Mitchell Sanders, the radio/phone operator, acts as Ted Lavender's mentor. Lieutenant Jimmy Cross is our platoon leader. He's young, inexperienced, and is overwhelmed by the responsibilities he has. He loves Martha, who could care less about him, and feels responsible for Dad's death due to his lack of attention to detail. This leads, ultimately, to his decision to camp in the ship field, where I meet my maker. Rat Collie was a company medic who was kind, but circumstances brought out his cruel side from time to time. He loses sanity slowly due to the casualties of war. After not adjusting to change, sleeping by day, moving by night, and imagine a sense of constantly being attacked by bugs, shoots himself in the foot to get sent home.
What is it good for? Absolutely nothing. Listen to me.
Henry Gobbins is a large man who is gentle and kind. He's a machine gunner who carries lots of ammo because he is a huge target. He's also very superstitious, which is why he wears his girlfriend's pantyhose around his neck, like some sort of good luck charm. Norman Backer was and is a true soldier. He liked the war and was good at it. Without it, he's a lost soul. But to his credit, he did try to save me that night in the field. Repeatedly, now after the war, haunted by his memory.